He okayed overtime for us and an APB to all precincts.
Eyes blue, hair black, mustache.
We certainly do know it's Sunday, Captain. We're on OT here ourselves, sir.
That's right. Anything budges, you call us at the 14th.
Trust me, Samuels is going to understand. I know this. This is a statute of limitations deadline.
How'd you get to be a cop with a face like that?
Plastic surgery. I'm angry. You're angry. There's a woman who's going to spend the rest of her life in a wheelchair. So we get this guy, okay?
From the BQE interchange all the way out to anywhere you want to go if you're heading normally.
$4.49. 11 minutes to go. Boy, what a week. Thank God it's Friday, huh, Marcus?
To tell you the truth, Victor, I'm really not looking forward to this weekend. Claudia finally nailed me.
We're painting the family room this weekend. All weekend.
Can't you get out of it?
I've been getting out of it since summer. I've run out of excuses.
That's one of the problems about being married. Me, I go home, flip a pizza in the microwave, grab a can of suds, and turn on the Knick game. Tomorrow I work out in the morning, check out the cosmetic counter at Bloomie's for those stews on layover. Then I pick up Bon Bon, I go for sweet and sour pork at Fong Shanghai Garden. Then third row center at the Barry Manilow concert.
Sounds positively idyllic, Victor.
It's this little inn on the Connecticut River near White River Junction. Oh, Vermont's supposed to be gorgeous this time of year. I know. I hope it rains all weekend. Oh. Sounds very nice, Christine. Dory's been on the swing ship for 2 weeks. We've been like ships in the night. So, what are you and Harvey gonna do this weekend?
Get a new bedroom set. There's a sale at Kramer's, 23rd Street, if you wanna go. 40% off.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, after 15 years, we're getting a new bed. And a dresser.
That's great.
DD5s?
Not yet, sir. But first thing Tuesday morning.
Wednesday
morning.
You know, the only one in this entire squad whose paperwork is up to date, Detective Petrie.
Well, some people are disgustingly compulsive about their paperwork.
The mark of a good detective is a neat file cabinet.
Let me guess. Aristotle.
Close. McGuire, Detective's Manual, 57 edition. Have a nice weekend.
Same to you.
Yes, Inspector. I understand, Inspector, but it seems to me... Well, we do have extremely heavy caseloads. Yeah, I realize that is no excuse, but... Yes, Inspector. Yes, I will see to it that it's taken care of.
I have an announcement to make. You may remember we had a team from Inspections Division in here last week to inspect our files and our paperwork. I have just had their report read to me now over the phone by Deputy Inspector Nellman. And you will all be proud to learn that the 14th has been given the worst evaluation in this area in the entire department. Word that they saw fit to use more than once was dilatory. Dilatory. DD-5s are backlogged. Property books are missing. Expense vouchers are misfiled. And open case files are not cross-referenced with the master file. I could go on. Deputy Inspector went on for 20 minutes. Only exception to this exemplary performance, singled out by the team, is Detective Second Grade Marcus Petrie, whose files and whose paperwork are complete, legible, and up to date. Well, I have assured the Deputy Inspector that this situation will be rectified Monday morning.
Monday, sir.
Monday morning! Petrie, have a nice weekend. All the rest of yous, tomorrow morning, you report here and you remain here until such time as all files are complete, correct, up to date, and legible. Is that clear?
Lieutenant?
I really don't mind coming in and lending a hand, sir.
No, I don't want you here, Petrie. You set an example. You deserve to have the weekend off. Let there be a lesson to your fellow detectives.
You'll do anything to get at a painting this weekend, won't you? Well, there goes Bloomies in the gym.
You sure you're gonna be out of there by 12?
1 o'clock at the latest. Just paperwork. So Mary Beth and I decided we're gonna get in there 8 o'clock sharp. Put in a few hours' work. And then we'll still have our weekend.
Samuel's really low at the boom, huh?
Yeah. Want a quickie?
Yeah, you don't hurry through the finer things in life, Chris. We got all weekend and we never have to get out of bed.
Yeah, my kind of weekend.
Yeah, mine too. Melnick's waiting for me at Borough Hall.
Okay, you lose. Dory, be careful.
Don't worry. The stakeout's so cold, I'm planning on catching some sleep. I'll see you, babe. Thirty-two inches. Okay. All right. 79 inches.
79 inches?
Good. It's gonna be real tight.
What do you say we hang on the old stuff off? I mean, after 15 years, you get attached.
Mary Beth, you've been talking about replacing this stuff for 5 years. We finally found something we like on sale.
I know. I just.
What?
I'm remembering is all.
Yeah, I know. I remember when we bought this. $87 for the bed, $117 for the dresser. Seemed like a fortune.
King-size bed is very big, Hoff.
So?
So I'm used to having you close to me.
You don't have to use the whole bed. I can come visit.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
I'm glad, because when we fight, I won't have to sleep on the living room couch.
When did you ever sleep on the couch? Name one time you slept on the couch.
3 New Year's Eves ago.
You were drunk.
I was not drunk.
You were drunk.
I was happy.
You were stink-faced.
I was not stink-faced.
Then why were you leering at Benny's cousin?
Leering?
Leering.
Leering?
Leering.
I was giving her a napkin.
With your eyes halfway down her dress.
Mary Beth, we already had this fight.
Yeah, we did. Who won?
I don't remember. I remember making up. What do you say we give this old bed a send-off?
You were leering hard.
Face it, Mary Beth, they were hard to miss.
Done, right? Next. Okay, August 11th, 1980. Would you stop? August 11th, 1981. Grand Theft Auto, case number 16394D. 16394D, August 11th. Nothing.
I mean, nothing.
Wait a minute. 16394D, August 14th.
According to the case file, we interviewed witnesses on the 14th.
Well, what is it, the 11th or the 14th?
I mean, does it really matter? The guy's serving time. We call Attica and ask him. I bet he remembers.
How's it going?
It's going.
Yeah, nice way to spend the Saturday, huh?
We got work here, okay, Victor?
But who doesn't?
August 14, we were interviewing witnesses.
All right, I'll change it here.
Hey, where's the smoke shop from?
Hello?
It's a bad check artist. We brought him in Wednesday.
Can I borrow this for a minute?
Just bring it back.
Yeah, yeah.
So what are we gonna do?
I'll fix it here.
On 14th?
Yeah.
Okay, 14.
Wait. Okay, all fixed. What's next?
Wait a second.
Mary Beth, come on, let's get out of here.
Hold your horses, Miss Bainey.
What's next?
What then, would you?
Mary Beth, did you write it down?
I can't think. So what have we put? 14?
Yeah.
Same guy.
Where'd this come from?
It's a case Petrie caught before we were partners. He's been after the guy for years. He even carries a copy of the composite in his glove compartment in the car.
Petrie's been after a guy for years on bad paper?
It wasn't bad paper. There was a push in assault and robbery in Stuyvesant Town.
Let me see your file.
He beat the hell out of a woman for 13 bucks. Put her in the hospital.
We had this guy in here Wednesday. Kurt Brennan. Thought he was a bad paper pusher.
Who is he now?
Central booking. Unless he was arraigned, then he'd be in Rikers.
What's the date today?
19. Who are you calling?
Central booking. Statute of limitations on the felony expires midnight tonight. Yeah, it's Detective Cagney, 14 squad. Yeah, I'm calling about a Kurt Brennan. Yeah, we brought him in last week.
If we can get her to make a positive ID on the mugshot, we can file in the assault before midnight. Marcus, if you want to come in. Beats painting, huh?
Are you sure? When? All right, give me the name. Okay, thank you.
He's not there.
He was there till yesterday, 4:20 p.m. Someone bailed him out, $5,000 bond.
She needed emergency surgery, and we couldn't talk to her for 48 hours. By then, her memory was pretty hazy. But we got the composite from her and two witnesses who saw it go down. Nice work, Victor.
I'll never forget that woman. She was a teacher at City College. Bright, funny, full of life.
Brennan walks on the assault charge at midnight.
No, we can get him before then.
You got that right.
I thought you were going to Vermont with Dory.
You don't want to get him?
Guys, we have 14 hours and 37 minutes.
Mary Beth, you want to trip over this guy next week and have nothing on him but bad paper?
What about the files?
So, trust me, Samuels is going to understand. I know this. This is a statute of limitations deadline.
We should call him.
The call number he left for the weekend was South New Jersey area code.
Roxanne?
I didn't ask, Victor.
Hey, we should be so lucky, guys, huh? If we need a warrant or backup, then we will call Samuel.
You call him.
I will call him. Mary Beth and I will go see the bail bondsman about Brennan's address.
All right, I'll try and see if I can get a hold of the woman. We'll need her to make a positive ID.
Aces.
This thing with Roxanne's heating up.
What do I care? What?
Who are you calling?
Oh, if he's picking me up at noon.
Mary Beth, we'll probably be back before noon. If the bail bondsman doesn't pan out, we have nothing.
Hold your horses. Nuts. You got the bail bondsman's address?
Yes, I do. 719 East 11.
Okay.
Marilyn George home. This is Detective Petrie, 14th Squad.
Cashing amount of 10% of the bail, a cashier's check, or an assignable title deed on real property in the state of New York. Listen, lady, I'm not the angel of mercy. I'm a bail bondsman. This is a business. 24 hours a day, even on Christmas and New Year's. Yeah, the reforms on the wall, you fill them out, you come back, we'll do business.
14 squad.
Don't tell me. A failure to appear.
We don't know that yet, sir. We need information on someone you wrote a bond for. Kurt Brennan.
Brennan. You want to discount a second on a nice apartment house in Brooklyn?
I beg your pardon?
You put up garbage for collateral, and I, out of the goodness of my heart, accept it. Brennan. Here we go. Brennan Kurt.
You got an address on him?
Well, ain't gonna do you much good. It's a care of. A woman named Rochelle Zimmer posted bail $500 cash.
Can we have an address and phone number on her, sir?
You know, I don't have to give you this information without a court order.
I know, but if you don't, see, then we have to call the DA's office, and then the DA's office calls the legal bureau, and a judge has to fill out a subpoena, and then they serve you, and you end up having to give it to us anyway. So why don't you just save us in the city a lot of time, Joel?
How'd you get to be a cop with a face like that?
Plastic surgery.
And a sense of humor. Work or home?
Both, please. Thank you. Rochelle Zimmer, mind if we ask a couple questions?
Give me a break, will you? Saturday's my busy day.
This is very important, Miss Zimmer. Kurt Brennan. He's wanted on a felony assault.
What makes you think I know him? Because he signed the bail application. So I got a soft heart. I don't know where he is. Rochelle. So how much do you charge for a manicure?
Lacey. L-A-C-E-Y. Beg pardon? L, as in liverwurst. 14th squad. Do you have a parole officer listed on a Kurt Brennan? Brennan. B, as in bedroom set. I don't know, sir. That's how come I'm calling you.
Calls me like it was just yesterday. I hadn't talked to the guy in 3 years.
Did you put up the bail money?
Yeah. Should have my head examined. It's here today, gone tomorrow. Friday night, we're out doing the town. Dinner, dance, and the whole number. Wake up this morning, he's gone. He didn't even leave me a note.
Is he gonna come back?
I'm not making dinner for him, if that's what you mean. Kurt's the kind of guy you shouldn't get within 10 miles of. I met him in a disco in the village. He's got these eyes. Really put you away. You know what I mean? One day he's loaded. Next day he's hitting you up for cab fare. Walks in here 3 years ago. Says we're going to Atlantic City. Just like that. He rents a limo. We take off. We check into this $200 a night suite. Sunken tub. Mirrors on the ceiling. Kurt hits the crap table. 2 hours later, he's stone broke. We're on a bus back to the city, and he leaves the next morning.
Is that the last time you saw him, before Friday?
Or heard from him. Must have found somebody else with a soft spot for blue eyes.
Rochelle, when was that?
June 10th, 1981.
You remember the date exactly?
I took the room service menu for a souvenir. You're not gonna hassle me for that, are you? I mean, it was out of state.
The statute of limitations on a misdemeanor is 2 years. You beat it, Rochelle.
Oh, thanks.
Look, we're gonna put some detectives outside your apartment. If he gets in touch with you, you give us a call, all right?
Sure, why not? You got nice nails.
Thanks.
Hi.
Hi.
Is Chris in the squad room?
They're out on something. They'll be back any minute.
Yeah, a little early. You mind if I sit down?
Suit yourself.
Maybe he'll show back up at Rochelle Zimmer's. With this guy's track record, I wouldn't count on it. I'm so ticked off. I mean, we had him right here in the holding cell 3 days ago. But we don't have him now. So what? Let's clean up the files and get out of here. Hiya.
Hi.
Sorry, we were doing outside. Something.
Dory, it's just gonna be a few more minutes. We have to finish the files, okay? You wait for me?
Excuse me. The woman's in there with Petrie.
The woman?
The victim in the statute of limitations case.
Be right back.
Yeah, excuse us just a sec. Hiya, Harv.
Hi, Chris.
What are we gonna tell her? We don't got the guy.
So we get what we can from her. She's probably blocked the whole thing out anyway. It's been 5 years.
Sorry, Hoff.
It's okay.
We can't quit now. See, I got a line on this parole office. I got some ideas, and say one of them pans out, I'd kick myself forever, Hoff. I mean, he put her in a wheelchair. He screwed up her life.
Mary Beth, it is okay. I will go down and get it myself.
Well, are you going to pick out our bedroom set by yourself?
Well, what's the big deal?
Hoff, no. I have to live with that bed another 15 years more.
Okay, we'll do it some other time.
Oh.
What?
Okay, what do you say I get out of here by 5 o'clock? Maybe we get lucky.
You figure we make Kramer's?
Kramer's doesn't close till 6. And we could call Brenda, tell her give the boys dinner, and maybe, you know, go out, get something to eat, see a movie. I mean, how often do we get a night in the city by ourselves Saturday night?
Luigi's 38.
Pizza and anchovies.
Best in the city.
Double anchovy.
Okay.
I'll call you when I know
okay,
something.
You be careful.
You call Brenda.
The guy's got a sheet. His parole officer thinks that Brennan's getting ready to unload.
You gonna work the fences.
Well, he mentioned two places where Brennan's unloaded before. One's a pool hall, one's a bar, so we're just gonna split up and cover it.
Well, I might as well take the car back then.
Why? You've already paid for it for at least a day.
What am I gonna do with it?
Dory, come on. If I can get out of here by early tonight, we can still make it. It's only a 4-hour drive. Huh? Tomorrow morning we can wake up in Vermont. Please say yes.
Chris, even if you trip over this guy, you still gotta do the paperwork.
Well, if Petrie and Specky do the paperwork. Come on! One day in Vermont is better than nothing.
How about a sleazy motel in Brooklyn?
Oh. Okay. I gotta go.
Mary Beth!
This is a stakeout, Doctor.
Yeah, but we're supposed to blend in. Hey, I start out slow. 9-ball. Down on the 3 and the 9.
You want a cup of coffee?
No. Thanks, anyway.
Planning something for the weekend?
There's a furniture sale downtown.
Oh, yeah?
How about you?
Vermont.
Vermont. Heard it's real nice this time of year.
Yeah, it is.
Three minutes after 4. Time flies when you're having a good time. I should call Harv, tell him to forget about dinner.
Let's give it a couple more hours.
Yeah.
We've flown the whole afternoon already.
Yeah, well, at least it's not raining.
Well, there you are.
He just bought the ranch, Marcus.
Just shoot the ball, okay, Victor?
Yeah.
Ace in the corner. There's something wrong with this table.
I'm here for Detective Especki.
You must be Bon Bon, right?
Yeah, Bon Bon the Chocolat. Yeah. Pleased to meet you. Victor's spoken of me?
Incessantly.
Oh.
Yeah. Now, the Chocolat, is that French or what?
No, stage. I'm an exotic dancer on Canal Street.
Oh, that's very interesting.
Yeah, well, we have a date tonight at 6, and he said we should meet here at 6.
Yeah, well, he's on an assignment right now.
Well, we have an 8 o'clock curtain for Barry.
Well, when he calls in, I'll tell him you're waiting.
Oh, well, that's very kind of you, Sergeant.
Coleman. Sergeant Coleman. Why don't you, have a seat?
Oh.
Public morals is downtown, honey.
I beg your pardon?
I'm sorry, Harv, we didn't get lucky. Christine doesn't want to give up on it, neither do I. I mean, it's only 5 more hours, and what if the guy shows up between now and midnight?
It's okay, it's okay. We do it some other time.
You're the best. The best. I'll make it up to you, I promise. Is Dory still there?
Yeah, he's right here.
Chris says, tell him he might as well take the car back, and she'll see him a little after midnight, okay?
You be careful, okay?
Always.
I love you.
Me too.
Still couldn't reach Samuels. The men are okay. Tune on white. They didn't have prosciutto.
Couldn't at least get the tuna on rye.
If you don't want to eat it, I'll eat it.
What a lousy way to spend a Saturday night.
We've had words.
Name one.
February 19, 1983. We was taking out the United Nations mission to the Republic of Zaire. We were eating pretzels. He was inside eating caviar.
Okay. A hymn we got.
Eventually.
You owe me one weekend in Vermont, Buster.
Well, this is nothing. I've been on stakeouts 48 hours straight. Anyway, you ought to be used to it by now.
Oh, you never get used to it.
Yeah. My ex-wife used to say that, too.
I didn't know you were married.
Oh, yeah. 12 years. Got divorced in 79.
Kids?
Two. 10 and 14. I see them a couple of weekends a month. How long have you been married?
Growing on 16.
That's terrific. You two are real tight, aren't you? I envy you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, just what it says. Divorce rate's sky high for cops, you know. Look, Harvey. I know you got some feelings about what happened. I'm sorry about that. I got myself messed up, but that's history. I'd like us to get along.
Why?
Well, our women work together. It'd be nice if we got along, too.
Never walk into my house with drugs again, McKenna. I'll throw you down 4 flights of stairs.
Look, I thought I'd just apologize.
I just want to make sure we understand each other.
I understand.
I'm 43 years old. I work with my hands, and I like it. I got a wife and 2 kids I'm crazy about. We got a good thing going. Somebody messes with it, I become violent. I protect what I got. That's all there is to it. Now you understand me. You want to get along? We can get along. Okay.
Right on that one.
Maybe somebody tipped him off.
Maybe.
That's a 9-ball, Victor.
I know. How much does that make?
$28.
You want to quit? Rack them up.
It's Tuesdays and Thursdays at NYU, and the course is called 19th Century Romantic Poetry.
That's nice.
I got a B+. Well, I work at night, so it's hard to study.
Oh.
I mean, did you know that Elizabeth Barrett Browning was a better poet than her husband?
No kidding.
Yeah, he was a real lox.
5-2. What a waste. We haven't even cleaned up the files. We could go in tomorrow.
We could. I'm not going in tomorrow. I don't care. Samuels can yell his head off. I'm not giving up my Sunday to do paperwork. It's not like we've been goofing off all day.
Come on, let's go home.
No. 5 more minutes.
3 minutes, 15 seconds. Your watch is slow.
Oh. Chris, do you see Brennan walking down the street here?
I'm not moving till midnight.
All right. Where are we supposed to pick up Petrie and his backyard?
89th and Broadway.
And on Mondays and Wednesdays, I take a poetry writing course. I'm a real Renaissance woman.
I should say so.
Hey! Would you like to hear some of the poetry I wrote for my class?
Victor's gonna be here any minute, I'm sure.
Oh, it's no trouble. This one is called Bryant Park at Dusk. Pigeon droppings flake the bum-congested benches of this island oasis amidst the cacophony of raucous taxi horns and the egregious rumbling of crosstown buses belching their carbon monoxide fumes in the penetrating dusk. What tragedies ensue in the radioactive half-life of Manhattan's gathering dusk? Let me count them.
One.
Victor!
I can explain.
Yeah, please do.
Excuse me, you guys must have something to do.
Oh, no, don't be silly, Victor. We don't. Introduce us.
Oh, Detective Christine Cagney, Mary Beth Lacey, and this is my partner, Marcus Petrie. Bon bon le chocolat.
How you doing, Miss Le Chocolat?
I've heard so much.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, if you'll excuse us, we have to chalk out.
I was on a stakeout. We were all undercover, and I couldn't use the phone in place.
Mary... Excuse me.
Listen, I'll make it up to you. We can spend all day tomorrow together.
How old's the blonde? Limitations.
What are you doing?
Listen to this. Come here. Criminal procedure law, Article 30, Section 10. In calculating the time limitation applicable to commencement of a criminal action, the following periods shall not be included. A. Any period following the commission of the offense during which the defendant was continuously outside the state.
It is 3:30 in the morning, honey. Now come back to bed.
You don't understand. The room service menu.
What?
Rochelle Zimmer can testify that Brennan was in Atlantic City for a 24-hour period on a specific date in 1981. You know what that means? It means that we have till midnight tomorrow to get him.
Tomorrow? Wait a second. I thought tomorrow we were going to spend together.
Well, but Dory, we get another shot at him here.
Christine, it's the middle of the night. Who are you calling?
Mary Beth. Hi, Harvey. It's Christine. Listen, can I talk to Mary Beth? Yes, Harvey. I do know that it's late. Would you mind just waking her up and putting her on the phone? Thank you. Mary Beth! Guess what?
And the kids woke up, and nobody got back to sleep. Well, we'll all sleep tonight.
Who is it?
Detectives Cagney and Lacey. Morning, Miss Zimmer.
You know what time it is?
9:37 a.m., ma'am.
That is Sunday morning.
Ma'am, can we come in?
Look, if it's about Kurt, he hasn't shown and he hasn't called.
Well, this won't take a minute.
I got somebody here in some one-room apartment.
We could get a warrant.
All right.
Thank you.
I introduced you, but I can't remember his name.
So we got a description and a couple of known hangouts. There's transient hotels, SROs, restaurants, the subway. He's got to be here somewhere, doesn't he? 8 million people in the city of New York, we need one guy. Mary Beth, I give up a weekend in Vermont, and you gave up a new bedroom set on sale. What's that have to do with anything? Because it's personal with me now. I'm angry. Aren't you angry? We were supposed to take the boys to the Museum of Natural History today. Bob loves to tell them all about the Indians. Yeah, I'm angry. I'm angry, you're angry. There's a woman who's gonna spend the rest of her life in a wheelchair. So we get this guy, okay?
8 million people.
No, we can't reach him, Inspector. Yes, the weekend number he left doesn't answer. Well, sir, we'd like to circulate a mug to all uniforms and radio cars in the city. We'd like extra uniforms at all the airport and bus and train terminals, and we'd like you to authorize overtime for 2 tours of duty. Yes, I realize that's very expensive, Inspector, but we've got a statute of limitations deadline. Yes, yeah, midnight tonight, sir.
Shh, he's talking to Nelman.
That's right.
I had to beep him off the golf course.
All right, sir. Oh, no. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, yes, we'll keep trying him. All right, he okayed overtime for us and an APB to all precincts.
Great. Let's hit the phones.
Victor and I will take Staten Island and Manhattan.
Okay, Mary Beth and I'll do Brooklyn and Queens. Whoever finishes first gets the Bronx.
Done.
Do you have a precinct list for Brooklyn and Queens?
Sure. You don't have it?
Of course I have it. It's filed. Thank you, Beatrice.
Mary Beth. Thank you, Christine.
Not at all.
I told you. 6'1". Eyes blue, hair black, mustache. 175 pounds. Kurt Brennan. Yes, be his employee.
Yes, sir. We certainly do know it's Sunday, Captain. We're on OT here ourselves, sir.
We're asking the help of all precincts. Right. We're getting the mugshots duplicated now. You should have them within an hour.
Rudy's Pool Hall, 86th and Broadway. That's right. Anything budges, you call us at the 14th.
Yeah, the arrest warrant's current. All transient hotels west of 6 and south of 50. Yeah.
How tall? No, that's not him. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Sergeant.
Yeah, how's it going?
Well, we've got as much area covered as we can. Port Authority, Penn Station, Grand Central, LaGuardia, Kennedy, plus every cheap hotel and single room occupancy that we know of.
You still got 2 hours.
Not much. Thanks, Coleman. I'm really beginning to hate tuna fish.
Well, it's kind of hard to get prosciutto on pumpernickel around here on Sunday.
Detective Lacey, 14. Say again. Where?
All right, you stay put. We'll be right there. Yeah.
What?
Desk work in a flop house near Union Square. ID. The picture, the uniforms are already there.
Great, let's go. Petrie! Miss Becky, we got a bite!
Right behind you.
Detectives Cagney and Lacey, 14th. Is this the man you saw?
Yeah, it's him. He's in 307.
How many exits to this building?
There's only one. Otherwise, they steal the bed linen.
Fire escapes.
In the alley.
Got an elevator?
Are you kidding?
Uh-huh. You, make sure he doesn't touch the phone. Fire escape to the alley.
We're on it.
Want to open the door? We have a warrant for your arrest. If you do not open the door, you'll be adding resisting arrest to the charges.
He's not going to open that door.
Think he's armed?
We need a search warrant to break the door down. We go in there without it, the whole case is gonna fall apart.
So I'll call legal and I'll get a warrant.
3 minutes to 11.
There's a judge on 24-hour call.
We got the alley covered.
He's in 307. I'm calling for a search warrant. Very best upstairs. Want to use your phone?
There's a payphone over there.
Thanks for your help. Take to get a warrant over here. You told me the good judge lives in Scarsdale. We got 10 minutes, Mary Beth. 10 lousy minutes before this statute tolls. Now, see, we should have called and gotten the warrant before we left and just knew it.
I wouldn't have written a warrant without a detective there, Christine.
I know he's up there. I just know he's up there.
Hey, mister! Hey! What type of heat you got in this building?
Radiators.
No gas appliances.
Mary Beth.
Some of the rooms have gas stoves.
307.
Yeah, there's a stove in there.
Thank you. Thank you. Christine, come on.
What?
I got it. I can't remember the number. If an officer has reason to believe there's a life-threatening situation, he may enter the premises without a warrant.
Mary Beth, you're brilliant.
No, diligent. I've been studying for sergeant.
You got the warrant?
Victor, you smell gas come from that room?
Gas?
Yeah, gas. There's an odor of gas in this hallway, isn't there?
I smell gas. You smell gas, don't you, Victor?
Oh, yeah, come to think of it, yeah. I do smell gas in this hallway.
Hey, guys, you smell gas here?
1157. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, let's do it.
Brennan, we've been looking for you.
For what?
Number of things.
You got the SWAT team down here for bad paper.
How about first-degree assault and robbery?
That assault charge is rotten. The bell tolled last night.
Great. Spread them. Is that so?
I know the law.
Well, you're going to have plenty of time to bone up on your criminal law while you're in prison, Mr. Brennan. You can start with Article 30, Section 10, Statute of Limitations.
What are you talking about?
Atlantic City. Atlantic City. Isn't that great? Move.
By the way, Mr. Brennan, you do have the right to remain silent.
You do have the right to remain silent.
Gas must have been come from the next room.
Come on,
Mary Beth. What's he gonna say? It was a terrific color.
He's gonna wanna know why we didn't call him Saturday as soon as we matched the mugshot to the composite.
We did call him Saturday. We called him all weekend. He just didn't answer.
And wait till he sees that overtime report. He's gonna hit the ceiling.
Nelman okayed it.
He doesn't like Nelman.
So he yells.
Yeah, he yells. And he says we gotta come in here next weekend and do the files.
No, next weekend I am going to Vermont with Dory come hell or high water.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Morning, Lieutenant.
Morning.
Guess we ought to get it over with, huh?
Maybe we should mention how many times we try to call him, huh? What was it, 20 at least, right?
Easy.
20?
Easy.
Good.
Morning.
Morning, sir. So did you have a nice weekend, Lieutenant?
Oh, yes, I did, Kay.
Oh, excellent.
How was yours?
Well, Lieutenant, you know, we were cleaning up those files, sir, when we came across a mugshot. Turned out to be the exact same mugshot as... The thing is, sir, we didn't get the files done.
You didn't do the files, but I specifically asked that the files should be in order by today.
Well, you see, there was a statute of limitations deadline on an assault.
An assault? What assault?
5 years ago. It was Petrie's, but then Christina and I had this bad paper case last week. Turned out to be the same guy.
It was so weird. I mean, as Becky saw the mugshots on our desk and we ID'd the composite, thought we had the guy because he was supposed to be up at Rikers, but someone had bailed him out.
So we staked out a couple fences and we waited there till midnight, but nothing. So we went to bed and then Christine remembered about Atlantic City.
Atlantic City?
Rochelle,
Zimmer?
Zimmer, sir. She posted bail. She said that she was there with him in 1981.
Mm-hmm. In Atlantic City.
Atlantic City. And then Christine figured out that we had a 24-hour extension.
Article 30, Section 10, statute of limitations.
Right.
Lieutenant.
All this happened Saturday?
And Sunday, sir.
All day Sunday.
We tried to call, but the phone didn't answer.
The phone? Oh, yeah, listen, you write all this up in a DD-5, and I'll look at it later, okay?
Yes, sir.
Hey, listen. I want to see all those files in order by next weekend, come hell or high water.
I don't believe it.
Do you believe that? So we come in next Saturday morning, 8 sharp, work like beavers, and they were out of here by noon.
But we made the collar. We just gave up an entire weekend.
Maybe we could do them during our lunch hour.
Thank God it's Monday.